Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's Lockdown Playlist Chapel podcast, where we meet desert islands with Canford Chapel. And particularly warm welcome to this week's special guest, Mr. Hoey. Mr. Hoey, welcome.
Good afternoon.
Great to have you with us. As ever, for those who don't know you, could you just introduce yourself to us briefly?
Yeah, sure. I'm a relatively new member of staff, having joined about a year ago. And I've come late to teaching after 17 years in the army. And it's great to be back in a school again in a different guise and enjoying teaching maths.
So help us out here, because army to maths, people might say that's not quite as exciting a thing to be doing. Sell maths to the sceptic out there, will you?
Well, I don't know. It's a subject that can describe, gives us a language to describe the universe, and can be anything from, you know, something as trivial as describing how we roll a dice to, you know, something hugely sublime, ideas of infinity, planets orbiting around each other, and how numbers work. It's all good. It's as exciting as the army, just in a different way.
It's all good. Excellent. So we're thinking about the Desert Island Discs element to the podcast, thinking about songs that are helping us in lockdown. Before we go on to those, there's the Desert Island Disc type questions with a little lockdown twist. So let's go for those. So the first question is the standard. You can take a Bible, you can take the works of Shakespeare and one other book onto your desert island lockdown. What will you take?
Slightly bizarre. It's something I've not done much of, but I think if I'm going to have a lot of time on a desert island, then something like an origami book with plenty of something to make and just keep me occupied doing something a little bit different.
Yeah, alternative. I like that. Very good. And what would your luxury item be?
Without a doubt, if I'm on a desert island, hopefully there'll be plenty of breeze and I can bring my windsurfer. That would keep me very happy.
Right. OK, so the specific kind of Canford twist lockdown questions. In this endless lockdown you're in, what would be the hobby that you'd take up alongside your windsurfing?
I am spectacularly non-musical so far in life, but I'd love to give it a go, because I think lots of things, if you give them a go, actually you suddenly realise what actually is achievable. So perhaps learning to play a musical instrument. My little son, my eight-year-old son's just started to learn the guitar, and perhaps I could try and learn alongside him.
Brilliant. Okay, and what about if you have to play one game on Zoom for your desert island lockdown, what would your game be?
Got to be articulate. Yeah, that's something we enjoy as a family. My brother's an English graduate and my parents have been married together for 40 odd years. So it's a lot of horns with them, and an epic articulate battle is a challenge for me as a maths teacher. It's great.
Right. OK, so now we're going to move on from the questions to our first song. The first song is more of a generic option, a song that you associate with the times we're living through and that you think could be a help in those times. What would you go for?
Well, this is going to reveal something that people perhaps wouldn't expect, but I'm a bit of a fan of Frozen, the film. And I think Frozen 2 just came out shortly before the lockdown. I went to watch it with my little daughter. And the early parts of lockdown for me are summarised by exploring. We're lucky to live on site at Canford, and exploring the grounds of Canford, bits that we hadn't been to before, with my daughter Esther singing at the top of her voice, Into the Unknown. So perhaps I think it's going to be Into the Unknown. And I wonder if it also speaks to this era that we're in, where actually we're used to quite a lot of certainty in our lives. And at the moment, we've got a lot higher level of uncertainty, both the kind of as a nation and as a world, but also on a personal level. So perhaps there's something that speaks about that, and a bit of a relish in terms of facing up to the unknown.
Brilliant, thank you. Okay, so let's have a little listen then to a bit of Into the Unknown from Frozen 2.
Every day it's a little harder as I feel my power grow. Don't you know there's part of me that loves to go into the unknown.
Okay, that was a bit of Into the Unknown from Frozen 2. Now we're going to go into the second song from Mr Hoey. For those listening for the first time, our second song is going to be taken from the Psalms, the songbook of the Bible, and particularly trying to focus on some inspiring lyrics that might strengthen and help us in our faith during this lockdown. Mr Hoey, what's your psalm of choice?
Yes, so my psalm of choice is Psalm 121, and just the first two verses. And if that's all right, I'll read it to you. I lift my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
Brilliant. Thank you. Now, why are those verses particularly helpful to you?
Well, I love being in the mountains in the summer and in the winter. And so you might think that's just why. But really, whilst the mountains are a happy place for me, they're not the source of that happiness and they're not the source of that help. You know, for me, far bigger and far better, my help comes from the God who, and this psalm helps us to realise that our help comes from the God who caused these mountains that are so awesome and inspiring to come into being. But I would add that, yeah, mountains do help point me towards God.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, what you're talking about is lifting your eyes up to a bigger perspective. Is there a particular time when this idea of lifting your eyes up to that bigger perspective has been particularly helpful for you?
Yeah, I think on a number of occasions. But I think the occasion that comes to mind, I spent a reasonable amount of time in Afghanistan, and during some tricky times, it was awesome to be able to lift my eyes towards the mountains, which are often just to the north of where we were. And they had a level of kind of permanence and of stillness that was in real contrast to what was going on at the time. And in a place where life is difficult and fleeting in many places, they kind of showed a real permanence that is what's offered by God.
Absolutely, thank you. And I guess that leads us into my final question, our final song, song 3. And that's a Christian hymn or a Christian song that's particularly meaningful to you, that ties into some of those things we've been talking about in terms of lifting our eyes up, looking to God as that perspective in tough times. What song have you got for us?
Yeah, so this song's called Across the Lands, and it was my favourite song. I recently went away and spent some time in Chad in Africa, and I could only download 3 albums for one reason or another, and not much data out there, of course. This was my favourite song in 3 albums that I ended up listening to quite a lot, as you can imagine, over the course of 6 months. You know, rather aptly named in terms of being across the lands. In terms of what the song speaks to and the words, and you'll hear it in a minute, is that it starts with a similar vision of God as to the psalmist, as a kind of author of creation, but then just goes on to celebrate God's love and what it means probably at a personal level, certainly for me, but I think for many other Christians, that, you know, talking about Jesus coming to earth as a man, him dying on the cross and then rising again and bringing us back to God. And I think that's just a glorious and uplifting story for us all at a time when we need that perspective.
Excellent. Thank you so much for sharing with us today, Mr. Hoey. Thank you for your 3 song choices to add to our lockdown playlist and for taking time out of your schedule to speak with us today. And to everyone else out there, pray for God's blessing on us as we continue to navigate through these tough times. Thanks again to Mr. Hoey for sharing with us in this week's Lockdown Playlist Chapel podcast. Who'd have thought that he'd be a fan of Frozen? I'm struggling to imagine him singing along to Into the Unknown with his daughter Esther. But one of the big ideas that he picked up on in that song and across the interview is the idea of perspective. As we journey into the unknown with uncertainty lying before us, we can lift up our eyes. For Mr. Hoey, the majestic permanence of the mountains pointed him to the mountain's maker and helped him through tough times in Afghanistan. For us, it could be something else, but let's do try and lift up our eyes. Things are hard and it's okay to feel down, but when we're down, it's all too easy to turn it in on ourselves and lose all perspective. And so my prayer is that we're able to look up to the good things around us, perhaps to family or friends, perhaps to the place where we live, but above all, to God himself. So as we finish, let me say a short prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask that in the midst of the trials we're facing in this lockdown, please would you help us to lift up our eyes. Please keep us from looking in on ourselves and give us a bigger perspective on the extraordinary times we're living in, particularly helping us to count our blessings. We especially ask for those who are fearful and anxious at the moment, praying that they would know your help and your unfailing love. We thank you for the Exeat weekend coming up and ask that it will be a refreshing and restful time for us all. And we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Sing together.